Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series of videos I'm doing about MLOps and continue with the OpenBinod Toolkit from Intel. And in today's video, we will see how to transform the Qwen to VL with 2 billion of parameters to format IR from OpenBinod and to do some examples of inference in CPU. Recently, this model that is from the Qwen Kawin series of the models. This model has been developed by Alibaba Cloud Team. Is on these guys have been developing different families of collections of videos. The series Qwen 2 and Qwen originally. Qwen that was a text LLM, then on Qwen 2 and Qwen 2.5, which are well, they say that the models are video vision. Well, let me get the definition exactly. Vision language models. Essentially, this kind of an hybrid in between a vision transformer plus an LLM. And I will say that it's more a multimodal model, but well, the definition that they provide to it is visual language models, no? Which I will explain a little bit now the architecture. We already had a review on the channel. Here we will make a refresh of what we discussed in the previous video and also how to convert with the tools that OpenBinod provide to the IR format and be able to run the model into a CPU. So the model, as I mentioned, is a combination of a vision transformer with a LLM, the previous Qwen text LLM using only the decoder. We originally can accept as input images, text, and images or video, and together with a prompt in text format, and the model will answer us with the text, obviously with the and a response according to the question that we formulate in the text input, and it will use the images, the content of the images, obviously to produce the answer. To do this, the input it doesn't matter depending on what we have. We transform the content video vision with a vision encoder. This is a conventional or a enhanced vision transformer, which is able to accept images or videos with an arbitrary resolution, and then after that generate a sequence of tokens, and it's also possible to receive text. So we have two encoders, one for images and video, which is a conventional or an enhanced or modified vision transformer, and a conventional tokenizer to encode the text that we pass as a prompt. On top of the vision encoder and the text encoder, we have a merger encoder, which essentially combine the embeddings of video visions plus the encoding of the text. As we can have a dynamic or well arbitrary or then yeah well the arbitrary image resolution, the model is producing an arbitrary number of tokens per image, and this means that somehow it's not somehow, it's how it's doing. The model is just marking with some special tags when the tokens that belongs to the image or video start, and when it finishes, and essentially the same as you can see here. There is a location where you just insert the tokens produced by the image or video that you are including as a input. You can mix pictures and videos. It's not an issue for that. So far, it's less than the context windows of the model. The same with text. Obviously, the text at the end, once everything is passed through the different encoders, it's mixed with some fixed locations and tags explaining where is starting and finishing the different components of your input, image, video, or text, and everything after that is passed as input to the conventional Queen text LLM decoder, which essentially will produce the output of your according to the prompt that you formulate. So the model is including some, you can take a look to the documentation. I also will pass you the document. It's quite interesting read how they build this document, the use cases for what is it was designed, chat, well, you can do prompting as well using your images. You will see how it's able to analyze, for example, a graph that of a stock text line the case, or some plots about revenues, etc., OCR, segmentation or kind of segmentation, image description. So it's also including function calling, similar to what we had in other technologies like OpenAI or Gemini or Llama even or Anthropic models. And well, it's quite able, the model. The sizes, you have three sizes for this model, 2, 7, and 72 billion, and it's quite it's performing really, really well. I think we had here 2 billion 72, and I think we have at some point yeah, here, this is the one we are gonna use today. And you can see here how it's performing versus other models on the similar size. So practically it's beating any model in every benchmark. And I think here on the you had a comparison with models on the they are comparing Queen 272 with models like Claude 3.5 Sonnet and GPT-4o. You can check here, the numbers are really, really good for a model with such size. Really, really good. Even the small model is giving a numbers really interesting, really good numbers for the size that we have there. And MMStab, let me check, BQA, OCR, yeah, exactly, OCR. Check it out, these numbers. In OCR, they are producing, even the small model is producing even better numbers than GPT-4o or Claude Sonnet. So a model with the... and at the same time is performing very good in other non-computer vision tags. Perception text, agent benchmark, this is for the function tool. And yeah, you can take a look as well, the number of languages that is affecting. So it's really, really good, the model. And yeah, you can take a look here, all the so it can can work even with videos up to more than 20 minutes. The small models they claim to be running in small devices already. Multilingual support, Chinese, English are most European languages, and Japanese, Korean, Arabic, Vietnamese. It's really, really impressive what they have done with this model. Now we will check also, sorry to be jumping from one place to another, it's greatest. They already had models quantized to different with different algorithms and in different types. Number type. Integer 4, Integer 6, AWQ, GTPQ. So here you have here the original versions. The original one have, you may see here, 4.5 gigabytes. This is the 2 billion in floating point 32. And now when we convert it to IA format, we reduce practically 65% of the size of the model. When we are transforming the model to IA format, we will generate four components. The four main components, this is the language model, the Queen. The Queen is the model which is receiving the embeddings from video image and the embeddings from text. And after we mix it, we had an encoder for text, encoder for video image, and a merger. The merger is the component which is taking the embedding from video and the embedding from text and putting all together in a single embedding, which is the input of the text LLM, in this case the Queen LLM. And once we have converted, as I said, the size is reduced to approximately 1.5 gigabytes. Not a lot. So you see the encoder, the embedding vision is really small. So from 4.5, we reduced to 1.6, approximately 272, 13. 1650 approximately gigabytes, which is a very big reduction. In any case, the model is complex. It's quite complex, the operation of this model, is as you can pass the information through different components and then merge the different embeddings and then undo the inference. So the model, the operation of the model internal is quite complex. So here OpenBinod had designed some scripts to do the transformation and then on a class which revealed somehow the logic to do to generate text similarly to what we had in Transformers library. I've been preparing this notebook similar to what I did in previous videos. Later on, I will upload the model to the repository. You will be able to download it locally to follow up in your local environment. Here I pass you all the necessary links to you. Review the documentation. It's quite interesting to read the docs. The documentation, how they had been testing. Also, one of the names is that they are producing embeddings with capture, as I mentioned before. Spaces in 1, 2, and 3 dimensions, and then on what they say multi-rotary positions embeddings, and then on they are combining this specific embeddings regardless from where they are coming, text, video, or image, into a single embedding, and this is the job that this merger component is doing. Previous to pass the merged embeddings to the model for to the LLM for generation. Quite interesting architecture, performing, as I said, really well, and well, it's something that you probably need to have in your toolset of models to solve the business problems that you may are facing. So in my case, I'm testing this model to replace some of the functionalities I had now for image tagging and image description or summarization, and I just simply evaluating a model which allow me to do even OCR for these three use cases in a single model without the need to have multiple components for this specific. It's clear that if you had a component, for example, currently I had three different models for this purpose. I had for image description, I had Florence 2, also running in ONNX format. In OpenBINO. I have a model for tagging, a ResNet 50 architecture, just for tagging for classifying the images in according to the 1,000 classes of our efficient net dataset, and I also had a model to do OCR. All of them, OCR is purely done with teaser art. In this case, I'm thinking it or evaluating if I to do everything with a single model. I can do probably part of this stat already with Florence 2, with the base version of the Florence 2. I already have it, as I said, in OpenBINO, and it's performing. In OCR, Florence 2 is not working very well, only for a small images to extract not much text. It's not and it's really slow in comparison with teaser art for OCR purposes. The test I've been doing with the Queen 2BL is faster in CPU than Florence 2, but it's still not getting the same level of teaser. So I will continue testing. In any case, here the test I've been doing is in my local computer, and as you can see, the computer is not only now in this demo is not only being dedicated to do the inference. I'm also recording the video, presenting the libraries, running the inference on local, having multiple documents open that is also consuming CPU cycles. And this is obviously not the best scenario to run anything in CPU. If the test will be in GPU, it's another story, because you are not competing. Apparently, you are not competing for the use of the GPU like we are doing currently, at the time that we are recording the video and doing the demo in the Jupyter notebook. But okay, in any case, the it looks like it's much more slower than TaserArt, but still has chance because the model is not quantized. We can't quantize the model. This means that it will be able to run faster. The model now is running in IR format in 32 bits. And I think there is still room to improve this model. So I pass you the list of requirement to install this. As you can see here, for Torch, we are going to install Torch with only with CPU support, we download the transformation library from OpenBINO and the tools, the utils, sorry, for working in a notebook. This is everything from OpenBINO toolkit, selector, which model you want to convert. I've been working with the 2 billions. We just simply import here the conversion tool, and it's pretty much, so the maximum compression is just simulate compression of an integer four. This is compression, this is kind of optimizing the size of the layers, is not quantizing, and then on here the compress weight mode is just simply try to do a compression that mimic the size of an integer font, but we are not doing quantization. If we want to do quantization, we need to use a calibration dataset, and there is a similar process where you first of all compress, but at the same time you are changing as well the precision use for your numbers. In this case we are not changing the precision, we are keeping the precision, that in this case is floating point 32 or floating point 16, depending on the layer. This is how the data type that has been produced originally with the transformers library, and then on here the only thing that we are doing is compressing the different layers of the different components of the model. So the transformation takes around about 1 hour and a half to convert the 4.4 gigabytes of model into these four components that you can see here. And as you probably remember, the IA format, there are two files. One is the binary is the equivalent to the tensor, the PyTorch format or tensor. Sorry, let me show you. So there are the safe tensors. This binary is the equivalent, the binary format of our weights and biases. So, and the XML is just a description of the layers. This is like printing or making a print of the different layers of your model with some additional metadata. You can see here integer 64, floating point 32. We are not changing the data types. Here we are just compressing. And here in this this is the definition of the layers of your model. You can check here. We have a long definition, but it's fine. Okay, once it's transformed, we just load the class that OpenBINO designed to do inference. Here now, what OpenBINO did is just reveal the logic that internally was done by transformers, Hugging Face transformers, to make inference with the original Qwint 2BL, and as the compression process convert the original model in four different components, then we had to create an additional logic to mimic the process that the original library is doing under the hood. So that's why here we have a class that one convert Qwint model, which essentially is taking the four components we have, which are somehow is here this lang model embedded model text embedding models and the merger. There are four different components, and then we took all together. As you can see here, model, language model, image embedding model, image embedding merger, and text embedding model. So we had the four components and we had to make them work together. This is what is done here in this class, and then we are just mimicking the different how the library transformer works with the original model. So we are mimicking the forward, and essentially you can check in the details. It's essentially doing what I explained you at the beginning. You can go to the details. It's not very complicated to understand what is going here. But again, this is essentially done because in the transformation process, we cannot transform the model into a single component, as you have in the after training the model with the transformer library. So the only possibility we have here is export the different components of our model and then on reveal the technique. So for that purpose, we rely on OpenByNode doing that. Usually what they do is create a library which later on they include on one of the versions or as an extension of the library in Python, or the runtime in few words. Okay, and then once we had the model converted, we just create an instance of our model. The model is just pointing to the directory, and internally it's gonna load the four components that we have for this model. Other models had more components, other less, depending on the architecture. The tower bricks, for example, have more components because it's a complex model as well for embeddings and data, so text generation from image and text. But yeah, it's gonna depend essentially how is the architecture of the model. We will have more or less components. In a simple text LLM, we have a single component as well in IR format. In other models which are more complex, we have different components, especially the multimodal, or in this case, like they say, vision language model, we had more than one component, especially because we need to mix or to combine the embeddings from text and the embeddings for video image. So we take here some examples. These examples are exactly the same that we did on the introduction of this technology, of this model. And here you can say, well, we didn't lose any quality. We are just, well, formulating some of the use cases, described image. Here we do this kind of description. One is the simple image text generation of what we have. So here one tip to you is, it's true that the model is accepting any kind of the resolution. It's not a problem. You can send whatever you want, but you have to consider if you send a image that is very big. Obviously, this image is, as you can imagine, is producing a very long sequence of tokens, which finally is part of your prompt, no? Of the prompt that later we will pass as input to the Queen text LLM. So. The recommendation, and it's also something that you can read, is that even when you have the model accept any arbitrary, which is really simplified the pre-processing process, but I think it's good to take the advice from the fabricant, in this case Alibaba Cloud Team, to reduce the size of the model, the size of the image. So, for example, in this case, my image is 2048 by 1365. This image is really big, and essentially, we don't need that image to produce to be used as a part of the contest or as a part of the prone. We can reduce it to get the same output, and then on this way you will speed up the process, the generation process, because first of all you reduce your input, you don't need to lose quality on that. You just reduce the size. The model is going to understand it as well. It's pretty obvious. It will be able to make a good description. So obviously, you need to do a resize that keep the ratio of the image. You cannot make a deformation. If you make a deformation, you probably get a grown answer, or it will be interpreted differently. But this is because you are deformating the image, no? But if you don't deformate the image and you keep the quality and the ratio and the quality of the image, just reducing the image, the model will perform faster. So here we do a description. Here just we ask to enumerate the object that there is on the image. Here we just ask the model to interpret a plot. And you can see as well, we are doing limiting here the max number of tokens. You can extend the number of tokens that it generates. The model is again, this is very small model, and you can see here the quality of the answer is really, really good, and everything working in a CPU. The speed is not fantastic, but well, I think is possible to work with, especially the system is dedicated only for inference. You can see here how you can modify it, just simply sending some para attributes in your prompt, sending how much resolution you want for a video. In this case, we are working here with video format. This is simply a baseball. 3 seconds, then we are going to ask for a description. You can see here we don't change the model. We are working with video, images, different use cases. The description of the model just simply stopped because we had only 120 new key tokens, and here we are doing OCR also with a PNG image, and then you can see here the quality really, really good. So this is not very complicated extraction, but in any case, it's practically perfect, the extraction. So the model again is something that is really worthy to keep an eye on it, on this series, on this fabricant, because the model has really, really good quality. Okay, that's pretty much all. I will upload now the video to YouTube and the notebook to the repository. This way you will be able to later on download it and work in your local computer. I will put a pointer into the description of the notebook, into the description of the video, and you will be able to find it in the repo, as I used to do. And that's pretty much all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting, useful for your training, for your job, for whatever reason are you watching this video. And if so, give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't subscribe before, and yeah, it's share with your friends and colleagues, and make comments on all this stuff that helped me to grow in YouTube. Thank you very much, and see you soon.